I would now call upon Nilanjan Mukhopadhyay. Nilanjan, 10 committees and commissions, an SIT with a second extension, effectively third because it was meant to deliver in the first 6 months, and yet we are nowhere near justice. It is understandable why the Congress stonewalled the process of law. Why do you think other political parties did not pursue it? They could have benefited hugely politically. As a result, everyone, almost everyone, seems cynical today. Kuch nahi hone wala. What is left as a way forward then?
The Sikh Forum, Mr. Pushpinder Singh Ji, Justice Anil Dev Singh Ji, and respected fellow panelists and friends. I will begin by replying to Harminder's question in a slightly roundabout manner, because that is the best way to possibly start, not right on the basic issue that is it time for us to turn cynical or not. 32 years ago, at almost exactly the same time, in a South Delhi colony, I joined a group of people, none of whom were Sikhs, to patrol the streets of the colony to ensure that the Sikhs who stayed there were safe through the night. I did not live in that colony. I joined there because a family of a very close friend, they stayed there. For several days, we patrolled very regularly every night, and I think we managed to keep the attackers at bay. They would try to come during the day, but during the nights, at least the group of 25-30 people, I was among the young people at that point, we managed to keep them at bay. After the immediate crisis was over, through some friends, I got in touch and learned about the emergence of a Nagrik Ekta Manch. The first memory which I have of in the morning of walking into Lajpat Nagar Bhavan and seeing a sea of humanity, the majority of which I just say, majority of which did not sport a turban. Professor Narang was talking about the fact that the Sikh Forum was formed through the process of the relief and rehabilitation process which was going on. I remember conversations with Professor Narang, and there used to be another very warm association which I had. Fulkaji, I did not know very well at that point, but Wing Commander Chhatwal. And I would keep arguing, ki aapko Sikh Forum banane ki kya zarurat hai? Can't you see all of us? Why do Sikhs have to articulate the concern, the pain, the agony, and the suffering of the Sikhs? 32 years later, I feel quite ashamed to belong to a community which is not a Sikh. When I was writing my book, a large number of people asked me, you are a Bengali by birth, why do you write a book on Sikhs? Somehow or the other, this country has come to existence that you must fight only for yourself. Sikhs must fight for Sikhs because the others will not. Muslims must fight for Muslims because others will not. Thankfully, on 2002, there is a bigger community of protest and movement, probably because of other political reasons. The co-option of the BJP has probably not happened, or rather, the BJP has probably not been, quote-unquote, pardoned as quickly as the Congress was probably, because they were very much part of the entrenched system. I think somewhere or the other, we have failed ourselves as a nation by underplaying the communal element in the 1984 violence. True, yes, there was a very active involvement and enabling factor of the Indian state at that point. But we probably have ignored the latent communalism which was there. The Sikhs deserved it. Somebody had mentioned before me. Ek mahol ban gaya tha, right from the 1970s ke, post-emergency period mein. And because of that, there was this feeling of suspicion, fear towards the Sikhs. Most people don't remember that in 1982, when we had Asiad in Delhi, buses coming from Haryana and Punjab were stopped at the border to check for Sikhs, and every Sikh was asked to get down and prove their identity. If they could not prove their identity, who they were sent back. So there was a build-up. So after Indira Gandhi was assassinated, there was possibly a general feeling within the non-Sikh population that they are responsible for the assassination of Indira Gandhi and for the actions of a very few people. The entire community was penalized. The state of the time, the government, utilized the sentiment. I think we got to go back when we actually look at what is to be done in future. When we say that the roadmap ahead, we must not only look at it purely in terms of legalistic terms and purely in terms of ki kisko kaise jail bhijwaye, kisko kya kya saza dilwani chahiye. Hum kaise ensure karein ki agle saal jab hum fir se pehli November ko yaad karne aaye to itne kam gair sikh nahi ho. Ye hamari failure hai, chahe aap sikh hain, chahe aap gair sikh. Having said this, you know, I feel that 1984 remains very important for four very specific reasons. Pehli baat to ye hai ki never before and never after there has been that scale of mass violence. In the city itself, 2,733 officially dead. Kanpur and Bokaro also has a fair number of people who were killed. There have been several other cases where, which were not documented at that time, but whose evidences came out. Gurgaon ke paas Hund Chiller naam ka gaon, jiske baare mein kuch pata nahi tha, aaj se 7-8 saal pehle tak. Mere kitab karte samay kai aise logon se baat hui, jinhone kaha tumko pata ki hum Indore mein phans gaye the train mein, humko wahan se wapas jana pada. Research karke yaad aaya ki are Coimbatore mein bhi attack hua tha, tab yaad aaya ki Bengal mein bhi hua tha. Mere Sikh mitr the jinki kafi flourishing business thi Kolkata mein, unko us samay Kolkata mein apne business ko band karke Delhi aake dobara se restart karna pada. Us dauran hum log baat nahi karte the, nahi poochte the ki bhai sab kya wajah thi, kyunki kaha jata tha ki purane dard ko kuredna nahi chahiye, you should not actually ask very unanswerable questions. So that was the first reason. That us scale ka violence nahi hua tha, isliye 84 remains a watershed in the history of communal violence. I call it a communal violence sponsored by the state, backed by the state. Dusri wajah jo thi ki wo jo pradhanmantri tha, desh ka jo mukhiya tha, uska pehla public assertion ghatnakram ke kareeb 15 din ke baad usko justify karne ke liye tha ki jab bada ped girta hai tab aisi cheeze hoti hain. इसके बाद जस्टिफिकेशंस और हुए हैं उसी तरह के कम्युनल वायलेंस के भी हुए हैं, उस पर मैं नहीं जाना चाह रहा हूँ क्योंकि उस पर फोकस नहीं है. अक्सर क्या होता है कि 84 की बात जब आती है हम लोग 2002 की बात करते हैं, पूरी डिबेट डिरेल हो जाती है, तो मुझे नहीं बात करती है. तीसरी जो चीज़ है कि जब पहला जो इंक्वायरी कमीशन बिठाया गया था उसको डिले इतने देर से उसको कॉन्स्टिट्यूट किया गया था, दैट शोड that there was a lack of intention of the government from day one. So we were fighting a losing battle from day one. Humko pata tha ki nahi jeetenge. Phir bhi ladte rahe, ladte ladte 32 saal pure ho gaye. Humko pata hai ki shayad umeed bahut nahi ki ja sakti, lekin uska matlab ye nahi ki hum log band kar denge. Chauthi jo baat hai jiske liye bahut important hai 1984 ko yaad karna, ki jin logon ko विक्टिम्स ने, आई विटनेसेस ने आइडेंटिफाई किया, जिनके बारे में प्राइमा फेसी एविडेंस कलेक्ट हुआ, जिनके खिलाफ ट्रायल हुए, उनको ओवर सक्सेसिव डेकेड्स उनको पार्लियामेंट में, अदर इलेक्टेड बॉडीज में हम लोग भेजते रहे, मिनिस्ट्री में हम लोग लेते रहे. फाइनली जाके 2009 में बिकॉज ऑफ अ ड्रामेटिक एक्शन सर्टन नॉमिनेशंस हैड टू बी विदड्रॉन बाई द कांग्रेस पार्टी टू सम अदर पीपल. These are the four main reasons as to why 1984 remains a very watershed issue in the country. कई बार बोला जाता है कि हमको कुछ करना चाहिए, What can we do? There is definitely a fight for justice. I am not an expert on legal issues, so I will stay out. I look at it primarily from a political perspective. Hindustan ke political history mein, jab bhi hum log riots, carnages, pogroms ki baat karein, 84 ki zikr jab bhi aayegi, ek cheez ki zikr hamesha hogi, either plus or minus, negative mein ya positive mein. Ki Manmohan Singh apologized in parliament. But is that enough? I think that the Indian political class owes it to the nation to collectively express shame for what happened in the country. I've been arguing very consistently that the time has come for us to campaign that besides whatever is being done to secure criminal justice, there must be a debate in parliament on 1984 once again, and there must be a collective sense of the house on this. If there could be a sense of the house on an issue like Lokpal, why cannot there be a sense of the house on such a major carnage or a pogrom? We keep on talking about the need for securing justice, ensuring that rehabilitation properly hope. But for that, there has to be a political campaign for which I think it's very important for us to not look at only from the perspective and the standpoint of only one community. I think the time has come to try to overcome those mistakes or rectify those mistakes which have happened in the past, and we build once again campaigns which unite all communities to ensure that justice is delivered for 1984 and for every other major issue where people have been targeted for various kinds of social conflicts and sectarian violence. Thank you.
Nilanjan.